المرسلين ثم الصلاة والسلام والتحية والإكرام على الأفضل الموجودات العبد المعيد الرسول المسدد المصطفى الأمجد والمحمود الأحمد سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا وشفيع ذنوبنا صاحب الوقار والسكينة المدفون بأرض المدينة أبي القاسم محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المظلومين واللعنة الدائم على أعدائهم أجمعين من الأولين والآخرين آمين يا رب العالمين. فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم وهو أصدق القائلين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات اللهم صل على I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the Almighty accept our tears that we shed for Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the month of Muharram and now Safar and heading towards the Ayyam of Arba'een, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts each and every word that I utter from my tongue for Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Anyone who recites for Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, our respected Janab, Muhtaram Mir Hasan Mir Sahib, anyone, whatever they have recited for the sake of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts that. And on the day of judgment, the reward for reciting for Imam Hussein is from Imam Hussein alayhi salam himself. By God, there is no greater rank, there is no greater status than to be the zakir of Sayyidu Shuhada. There's no greater rank. Man qala fina bayta shi'rin, Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam says, one who says for us one bayt, banallahu ta'ala lahu baytan fil jannah, Allah will build him a bayt fil jannah. Bayt in the Arabic has two meanings. One bayt is, you know, when you recite two lines of poetry, and then bayt in Arabic also means a house. For each bayt, Allah will give a bait in Jannah. Ya Ali. Marhum, before I begin, Marhum Allama At-Tabatabai, Sahib Tafsirul Mizan. Everyone knows Allama At-Tabatabai. His tafsir has gained more popularity in the Shia world than any other hadith for that matter. He says something beautiful. He says, all of the years that I spent teaching and studying and reading and writing in the Hawzat, he says, all of that on one side, one mercy of Imam Hussein is on the other side. Allama Tabatabai marhum. He says, I'd give up everything just to recite one marsiya for Sayyidu Shuhada. Marsiya for the Sayyidu Shuhada is no joke. Marsiya for Sayyidu Shuhada is no game. We don't realize, because we don't see the batin, we only see the zahir. We have recited marsiya, khalas, done. But the angels that descend to listen to the marsiya, if only we could see the angels that sit amongst the mu'mineen on the farsh azab Aba Abdullah. If only we could see those who come from amongst the other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By God, we would never get up from the farsh azab Aba Abdullah. The next few nights that I've been blessed to be here, I will speak inshallah on the topic Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein, divine caliphs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Divine caliphate, khilafat. As you know, Amirul Mu'mineen for us is the first khalifa. Imam Hassan for us is the second khalifa. Imam Hussein for us is the third khalifa. And Imam Sajjad for us is the fourth khalifa. This is our tartib of the four khulafa. Ali being the first, Sayyid Sajjad being the fourth. Imam Hassan and Imam Hussain in the middle. This is our sequence of the four khulafa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. When he made Adam, he said it clearly, indeed I am to make a khalifa in the dunya, in the world. You see, leadership, khilafat, imamat, qiyada, rahbariyah, leadership itself is so important in all nations, not just in amongst Islam. Amongst all nations, leadership is so important that it has become the most sensitive topic within the religion of Islam. As soon as Rasulullah closes his eyes, the ummah split into two sects. Why? Leadership. Those who went with Ali ibn Abi Talib, they became known as the Alawiyin, or the Shia as we say. Those who went with the other, the Khalifa who stood against Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, they were known as the Ahli Sunnah. And so Qiyada, Khilafa, Imama, leadership was so important that until today, 1400 years later, it still remains a sensitive topic. And will remain so until the Day of Judgment. In fact, even in this day and age, Khilafat is such a serious and sensitive topic that if you remember when Daesh, may Allah curse them, when they attacked Iraq, what did they say? We want to bring back Khilafah. We want to bring back Khilafah. We want to put our Khalifa in charge. They said, we will do anything to bring back Khalifa or bring back a Khilafah, a state, an Islamic state. That's what they said. And for that, they killed and they plundered and they looted. And they took the lives of many innocent Muslims and non-Muslims alike, especially the mu'mineen, the Shia. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala crushed them at the hands of the mu'mineen. However, throughout history, going back a few hundred years, the Ottomans, when they ruled from Turkey as far as Vienna in Europe, what did they say? They said, we are the Khulafa. Whoever was the Ottoman king was the Khalifa of the Islamic world. The point is, until today, Khilafat remains the most important subject within the religion of Islam. Imam Amirul Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu was salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. He says, leadership is so important that when two people go on a safar, go on a trip, when the two people should travel, one should be a leader, the other should follow him. This is how important leadership is. Even in daily affairs, you go for travel, even if there's two people, not even a caravan. Of course, if there's a caravan, it's very important. But even if there's two people, Imam says, make one of them a leader and the other should follow him. Why? Because leadership brings nizam. Leadership brings a system. And this is why, after Rasulullah was to leave the dunya, there had to be a leader. For what reason? To protect the Sharia. A muhafiz, the one who does hifaza. A muhafiz, someone who would take care of the Sharia of the Prophet. New religion. The religion of Islam, when the Messenger of Allah was to close his eyes, was a new religion. These people were new. Just only a few years back, they were worshipping idols. They didn't know halal from haram. They didn't know najis from tahir. Rasulullah was to close his eyes. What guarantee was there that Rasulullah closes his eyes, these people wouldn't turn back? You know what that guarantee was? Ghadir. Ali ibn Abi Talib was that guarantee. And hence, in Ghadir, it was not that this was the first time Amirul Mumineen's wilayat and imamat was announced. This was the last time it was announced. The first time the imamat and wilayat of Ali ibn Abi Talib was announced was in the house of Abu Talib. Ya Ali. The same time Rasulullah stood up in the house of Abu Talib and he says, I am the messenger of Allah, I am the prophet of Allah. Anyone who helps me, will be my vicegerent, will be my khalifa, my helper after me. Ali ibn Abi Talib stood up. Three times the hadith says, Ali ibn Abi Talib says, Labbayka ya Rasulullah, Labbayka ya Rasulullah, Labbayka. So this was the first time. There should be no confusion on this. Ghadir was not the first time. Ghadir was the last time. And had they allowed Rasulullah to write his will, he would have even written it down. But that wasn't allowed. Anyhow, so this was the last time. And so the deen of this new religion required a muhafiz who tells people the halal, who tells people the haram. When people forget how to pray, he tells them, this is how you pray. This is how Rasulullah prayed. And this is why after the three khulafa, when Amirul Mu'mineen came back to power, when they came and they knocked on the door of Imam Ali alayhi salam, he says, Ya Ali, only you and no one else is able to rule with fairness and justice. When Amirul Mu'mineen then accepted and he prayed salah and he led the prayer after a long time, you know what the companion said? By God, Ali prays like Rasulullah. Today we remember Rasulullah's prayer. In other words, deen had gone so far. From where? Deen had got so far from the actual point of origin. What was the point of origin? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. And so the religion had gone far. Amirul Mu'mineen brought it back. And so muhafiz was needed. Khalifa, Ali's Khalifa, Hassan ibn Ali's Khalifa, Hussain ibn Ali's Khalifa. All 12 of them are Khulafa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khulafa is the plural of Khalifa. Now this is important. Before I move any forward, allow me to say this. What is Khalifa and what is Imam? Inshallah, you're all with me on this, inshallah. What is Khalifa and what is Imam? You see, Khalifa comes from the word Khalf. Khalf. Khe, Lam, Fe. Khalifa. Meaning behind. Imam is from Amam, which means in front. And this is why the Imam is known as Imam, because he walks in front and the follower walks behind him. So this explains Imama, Qiyada. But what is Khalifa? What does it mean back? What it means is Khalifa or Khalf or Khalaf, which is the opposite of Salaf. Khalaf is the opposite of Salaf. Seen Lam Fe, Salaf. You know what Salaf is? Salaf is those who came first. Successors, predecessors. وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ, as the Quran says. Those who came first. This is important. You know why the Wahhabis, they say we are Salafi? Because of this word Salaf. What do they mean? They say we are Salafi. Why are we Salafi? Because we follow the Salaf. Who are the Salaf? The first ones who accepted Islam. The first ones who supported Rasulullah. The first ones who prayed behind Rasulullah. The first ones who said Labbaik Ya Rasulullah. We follow them, so we are Salafi. But what's interesting is that these people who claim to be Salafi are far from Ali ibn Abi Talib. Even though when it comes to Salaf, there is no one who was closer to Rasulullah than Ali ibn Abi Talib. The first to pray behind Rasulullah was Ali. The first to give zakat behind Rasulullah was Ali. The first to make hajj with make tawaf the Kaaba was with Rasulullah was Ali ibn Abi Talib. All of the ibadat, Ali was the first. In fact, the Ibn Abi al-Hadid al-Mu'tazili. Who's Ibn Abi al-Hadid? The Sunni alim who's written his commentary on Nahjul Balagha. Very famous commentary. He admits, he says, Ali ibn Abi Talib believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at a time when the companions were worshipping sticks and stones. So who's a Salaf? There is no one before Ali ibn Abi Talib who went towards Rasulullah. No one. This is why the hadith says that first Muslim in the Ummah was Ali ibn Abi Talib. Let me give you the hadith. from a Ravi by the name of Afif al-Kindi. What does he say? He says, I came into Makkah for business. He was a Tajir. He says, I came into Makkah and I sat by Masjid al-Haram with the Kaabais. And with me was Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib. He says, we sat for some time until we saw one of the Arabs come forward. His face was shining, illuminating like the moon. I had never seen someone who looked so pure. He came and he stood in front of the Kaaba. And then after some time of standing, he bowed and then he prostrated. He put his forehead on the ground. He says some time had passed that a woman came out covered in a veil. She did the same thing behind him. He says some time had passed, a young boy came out who did the same thing behind him. And he says, he was sitting with Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib. He says, oh, Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib, who is that man? Who is that woman? And who is that boy? He says, oh, Afif, that man in front who's praying is my nephew Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. He says, that man is my nephew, the messenger of Allah. He speaks of the oneness of God. The oneness of God. He says, who's the woman? He says, that is his wife Khadija. Then he said, who's that young boy? He says, that is his brother, his cousin, the son of Abu Talib. No one prayed behind Rasulullah before Ali and Khadija. So when the Salafi say, we are Salafi, which Salaf are they following? Who are they following? When the first one to pray behind Rasulullah was none other than Ali amongst the men. And let me give you something. Allama al-Amini. Khas tawajjuh. Allama al-Amini is who? Sahibe Kitabul Ghadir. Sahibe Kitabul Ghadir. Bahut mashhoor kitab hai. Very famous book. He traveled the world to write this book, Allama al-Amini. He's Iranian, in Najaf, studied in Najaf, lived in Najaf. Traveled as far as the libraries of Turkey, traveled as far as Misr, Egypt, traveled as far as Lucknow in India. Why? To collect all of the ahadith on wilaya. All of the ahadith on wilayat Ali ibn Abi Talib. Someone who was an expert in the wilayat of Ali ibn Abi Talib. He has collected this book in which he has collected the hadith of Ghadir. Man kuntum mawla, fahada Ali ibn mawla, from 110 companions. Generation after generation, Ravi with Ravi, connected, no shak, no shubha, no doubt in the authenticity of the Hadith Ghadir after that piece of research. It's an encyclopedia, 11 volumes are available, in total is 20 volumes. You know what he says? And this is important. He says, when all of the ulama have written that Ali ibn Abi Talib was amongst the predecessors, and what's interesting is, look at the fadil of Ali. Ali was one of the predecessor and he was also the successor of the Prophet. So whether you go for the Salaf or the Khalaf, you will always find Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ya Ali. Salamat. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. This is what he says about Imam Ali alayhi salam. He says, do not be fooled. And if tonight you can take this away from this lecture, I think I would be happy with that. Allama al-Amini marhum rahmatullah alayhi says, do not be fooled when people say Ali was the first to accept Islam. That is not the reality. That is not the case. Because to accept Islam, you've got to be a non-Muslim first. Tawajjuh hath agar mere saath hoon. Kya farmate hain? Kaha ke ye mat samjhe ki Ali ibn Abi Talib Islam laye to yani Ali pehle wala ayaz billah Isai the ya Yahudi the ya Mushrik the. That's not what it means. What does it mean when people say Amirul Mu'mineen was the first one to accept Islam, Amirul Mu'mineen was the first one to say his Shahada? He says that's not what it means. That is Islam-e-Zahiri. Ye Islam-e-Zahiri hai, Islam-e-Waqai nahi hai. Because to accept Islam, first you got to be a non-Muslim. And Ali ibn Abi Talib was the only one And this is a challenge that Imam Sajjad said in the Darbar of Yazid. He says, I am the son of the one who never for even the blinking of an eye put his head in front of an idol. मैं उसका बेटा हूं जिसने पलक झपकने के बराबर भी किसी बुत के सामने अपना माथा नहीं टेका. यूं मेरे मौला ने बता दिया, बुत शिकन और होते हैं, बुत परस्त और होते हैं. एक लहजे के लिए, not even for a moment, did my खुतबा इमाम सज्जाद इन दरबार यजीद, he said, not even for a moment did Ali ibn Abi Talib bow his head to an idol. The only one. In fact, Ali ibn Abi Talib has the azaz that he is the one who struck the idols. Like Ibrahim but chicken, Ali ibn Abi Talib but chicken. Durud bheji Muhammad Ali Muhammad par. And so, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Khalaf is from back, the one who is behind someone. That's why Khalifa is known as Khalifa. Back, the one who is behind someone. The one who takes, jo kisi ka qaim maqam ho, jo kisi ke piche uske baad mein aa jaye. Someone who replaces someone, someone who takes someone's position, someone who comes after him, behind him. Now you look through the life of Rasulullah, who was it that was always behind Rasulullah? Nahjul Balagha, Ali ibn Abi Talib says, ittiba'ul fasil athar umme. I walked behind Rasulullah like the child of a camel walks behind the she camel, the mother camel. Wherever the mother goes, the child goes in that direction. No one, never did I ever set my foot outside of the boundaries of Muhammad. Wherever Rasulullah was, you find Ali ibn Abi Talib. Rasulullah in battle, Ali in battle. Rasulullah in Medina, Ali in Medina. Rasulullah in Makkah, Ali in Makkah. Only one night, Shabi Hijrat, Ali ibn Abi Talib remained back. And that was to save the life of the Prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liked it so much that he says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْرِي نَفْسَهُ ابْتِغَاءِ مَرَضَاتِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ رَوْفٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. He loved Ali ibn Abi Talib so much, sleeping in place of Rasulullah. He says, I give Ali ibn Abi Talib my pleasure and I take his soul. His nafs, I take his nafs. And so, Ali ibn Abi Talib, wherever Rasulullah was, Ali was there. Ghar-e-Hira. The first revelation, jab Rasulullah Khuda pe pehli wahi nazil hui, us waqt mere maula kehte hain, main noor-e-wahi ko dekh raha tha. Main wahi ko sun raha tha. Yahan tak ke Nahjul Balagha mein maula ne kaha, ae Ali, Rasulullah Khuda ne kaha, ae Ali, aap wo dekhte hain jo main dekhta hoon. Aap wo sunte hain jo main sunta hoon. Bas farq ye hai ki aap nabi nahi, aap imam-e-ummat hain. Yali, you see what I see. Yali, you hear what I hear. Amirul Mu'mineen was the only one who knew the secrets of Rasulullah. Who came behind? Khalaf, from behind. So who came? It was only Ali ibn Abi Talib. When others deserted the Prophet in many of the battles, who stood shoulder to shoulder with Rasulullah? Sahib Zulfiqar. La fata illa Ali wa la saifa illa. Zulfiqar. No one except Amir al-Mu'mineen. So no one is more deserving of this position than Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen. And he says in Nahjul Balagha, you're not thake to nahi hazrat. If you allow me, I have some time. I want to make the most of my time. And I've come from too far to shorten the majlis. Amir al-Mu'mineen Nahjul Balagha, he says, look, you know my position to Rasulullah. When people came forward and they said, no, Ya Ali, people have chosen so and so as the Khalifa. You should accept it. You should, you know, you shouldn't protest. You shouldn't do ihtijaj. You should accept. People have accepted. So should you. Amir al-Mu'mineen said a lot of things in Nahjul Balagha. But this specifically, he says something beautiful. He says, you know my relation with the Messenger of Allah. He says, I didn't open my eyes until Rasulullah held me in his hands. When Amir al-Mu'mineen was born, Rasulullah takes Ali ibn Abi Talib into his hands. He says, Rasulullah raised me in his lap. Rasulullah would make me sleep on his chest as a child. As I grew older, Rasulullah would make me sleep beside him. He says, Rasulullah would make me sleep so close to him that even until today, I can smell the fragrance of Rasulullah. I can smell Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi. And then he says Rasulullah would feed me with his own hands. Rasulullah would train me with his own hands. Amirul Mumineen says, by God, I mean Rasulullah taught me what? He taught me 1,000 chapters of knowledge. From each chapter, Ali opened 1,000 more chapters of knowledge. He says, you know my relationship to Rasulullah. Has anyone got this relationship? Can anyone come forward and say this? So whether it's Ali, whether it's Imam Hassan alayhi salam, whether it's Sayyidul Shuhada, by God, the leaders of the dunya will not come close to the dust under the feet of Hassan and Hussain. Leaders of the dunya, the kings of the dunya, they may be kings, but they bow at the door of Najaf. They bow at the door of Karbala. Because they know the real kings are they. Shah Asta Hussain, Badshah Asta Hussain, Deen Asta Hussain, Deen Pana Asta Hussain. Sayyid al-Shuhada is what? He's the king of kings. He's the one who saved God. And this is what it is to me. This is what it is to be a Khalifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you save the deen of Allah. Not that you loot the Baytul Mal. You save the deen of Allah. He says, Sardat nada dast dar dast. He gave his head, Imam Hussein, but he didn't give his hand. He says, because I am the Khalifa, the Haqiqi. The real Khalifa does not give his hand in the hands of a tyrant, man-made. What does the Quran say? Inni ja'ilun fil ardi Khalifa. What does the Quran say? I made Adam. So what do we conclude? Allah makes Khalifa. The Khalifa is made by Allah, not made by people, not made in China, made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, I made Khalifa. And then he says, وَعَلَّمَ الْآدَمَ الْأَسْمَى كُلَّهَا. And then I taught Adam all of the knowledge. So he made him and he gave him ilm. So Khalifa is someone who's made by Allah and someone who has got ilm by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he says, I said to the malaika, اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا إلا إبليس أبى واستكبر وكان من الكافرين. He says, I said to the angels, bow to him. He's my Khalifa. Bow to my Khalifa. And so everyone bowed. Sabne sajda kiya. Sivai Iblis ke. Aba wastakbara. Inkar kiya. He rejected. Wastakbara. Mutakabbir hua. Takabbur karne laga. He says, why should I bow to him? وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. اور قرآن نے کہا کہ شیطان تو تھا ہی پرانا کافر. He was a kafir. So, what do we conclude? Khalifa made by Allah. The ayah that I used to begin the lecture. Khalifa is made by Allah. And there is no change in the sunnah of Allah. وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلَ. Quran. You will not find a change in the sunnah of Allah. We made Khalifa, Allah will make Khalifa. We gave him ilm, Allah will give Khalifa ilm. Malaika do ta'zeem of the Khalifa. So now you look in history and say, which Khalifa was honored by the Malaika? Where do you find Jibrail and Fitrus? Where do you find Mikael and Israfil and Jibrail in the house of Fatima? Sometimes they are cleaning the house of Fatima. Sometimes they are rocking the cradle of Hussein. Sometimes they descend. Why? Because Fitrus wants to do the ziyarat of Hussein. Where do you find the malaika? And so, before I come to Masahib, the last hadith I want to give you, and I conclude, one thing is for sure, anyone who rejects the Khalifa of Allah is a shaitan. Usul in the Quran, Usul. Hadith is from Usul al-Kafi, one of our major books. After the Holy Quran, the first major book of the Shia is Usul al-Kafi. Who is the narrator? Which Imam is it from? Imam Jaffar ibn Muhammad ibn Sadiq, salawatullah wa salamu alayhi. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad ibn Ali Muhammad ibn Ajil Faraja. The Imam says, I heard from my father, Imam Muhammad al-Baqir. Imam Muhammad al-Baqir says, I asked Jabir. You know, Jabir was that companion. Rasulullah says to Jabir, oh Jabir, you will live long enough to see my son, Muhammad al-Baqir. Give him my salams. Rasulullah gives his salam to Jabir to give it to Imam Muhammad al-Baqir. Sari dunya Rasul ko salam kare. Rasul khuda Muhammad al-Baqir ko salam kare. Ye hai azmat Imam Muhammad al-Baqir. What does the Imam say? He says, oh Jabir, tell me, when Imam Hussein was born, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hadith is known as hadith al-loh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down a loh, loh al-mahfuz, bal huwa Quran al-majid, fi lohin mahfuz. Quran ki ayat hai, ke Quran ko Allah ne loh al-mahfuz mein mahfuz kar rakha hai. Wo asli Quran hai, wo hakiki Quran hai. The Quran is saved in a tablet, safeguarded, protected in loh al-mahfuz. He says, when Imam Hussein was born, Allah sent down a tablet as a hadiyah to Fatima. And the Lady of Light, Fatima Zahra, recited what was written on this Lohil Mahfuz. To who? To Jabir. He says, oh Jabir, tell me what was in that. He says, the Lady of Light, she says that when this Loh was brought down by the angels in the hands of Fatima, she says, the Loh said, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Messenger of Allah. And the Lady of Light has been blessed with the Loh. And this hadith is so authentic that Ayatollah Wahid al-Khurasani has narrated this hadith in his Darsul Kharij. When he gives Darsul Kharij to, you know, to ulama, he narrated it there. And a marja'i waqt does not narrate a hadith unless he is sure of the authenticity. He says, the Lady of Light says, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says on the loh, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not send a Nabi until he selects his wasi. No Nabi is sent until his wasi has been chosen. And this is the aqidah of the Shia. Kisi bhi Nabi ko us waqt tak mabus nahi kiya jata jab tak uske wasi ka intikhab na kar liya jaye. Kisi bhi Nabi ko us waqt tak zameen pe bheja nahi jata jab tak uske nabi ka intikhab na kiya jaye. Isliye jab rasool khuda ne kaha kuntu nabiyan wa adama bainal mai wa teen, mere maulana ne kaha kuntu wasiyan wa adama bainal mai wa teen. Main us waqt bhi wasi tha. She says that, and then after that Rasulullah says the hadith says, and I'm coming to an end slowly. She says that Rasulullah sent the messenger, Allah sent Rasulullah, and then after he says, Allah says that I've chosen Muhammad to be the best of the prophets, Ali to be Sayyidul Awsiya. And then he says, I've chosen Hassan and Hussein. This is important. What are they chosen for? He says, I have made Hassan Ma'danul Ilmi. I have made Hassan Ma'danul Ilmi. I have made Hassan to be the cave of my knowledge, the cave of the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has chosen Imam Hassan alayhi salatu wasalam. All of my knowledge is in Hassan. What does he say about Imam Hussein? He says, وَجَعَلْتُ Husayna, and we made Hussein خَازِنَ وَحْيِ. All of ilm we gave to Hassan, all of wahi we gave to Hussein. You know what that means? This is important. This is really important because all of knowledge was given, ma'danul ilmi, my ilm was given to Hassan. Whatever the ilm of Allah is. Wa khazina wahi, all of wahi. Where does wahi begin? Wa 'allama al-Adam al-asma' kullaha. First wahi on the first prophet Adam. Where does the wahi end? Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinukum wa atmamtu 'alaykum ni'mat. The last wahi on Rasulullah. The first wahi on Adam. The last wahi on Rasulullah, last revelation on Rasulullah. All of revelation that ever descended on Adam, Nuh, Musa, Isa, Yaqub, Yunus, Ibrahim, Ishaq, Ismail, until the Messenger of Allah. All of those revelations were contained within the heart of Aba Abdullah. Nine why we say Assalamu alayka ya waris Adam Safatillah. Assalamu alayka ya waris Nuh Nabiyillah. Assalamu alayka ya waris Ibrahim Khalilillah. Oh, the inheritor of Adam, the inheritor of Musa, the inheritor of Isa, the inheritor of Ibrahim. Assalamu alayk. This is no small matter. This was Hussain, the Khalifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was Hassan, the Khalifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tamam ulume ilahi ki kaan hai mera maula Hassan. Tamam vahiyye ilahi ka khazana hai mera maula Hussain ka kalb, dil Hussain. Koi aisi vahiy nahi hai jise Allah ne dil Hussain mein nazil na kiya ho. پوشیدہ کر رکھا ہے سید الشہداء کے دل میں خدا کی قسم بہت بڑا مقام ہے میرے مولا حسین کا افسوس تو یہ ہے کہ دنیا حسین کو سمجھ نہ پائی the same heart in which there were all of revelations that ever descended on the prophets of Allah, that heart, you know, this heart was, the heart of Imam Hussein was unlike other hearts. The heart of Hussein was something special. وَجَعَلْتُ حُسَيْنًا and we made Hussein, the heart of Hussein, the container of all of revelation. But Asr-e Ashur, it was in the heart of Hussein, they pronged a three-headed arrow. أَجْرَكُمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ Whose heart was it that they shot an arrow at? The heart that contained the ulum of the Anbiya. The heart that inherited the Anbiya. Ajrukum ala Allah. Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, in his final moments when he sits down, there were many arrows that were fired. But there were only a few arrows which were three-headed. One arrow, the Maqtal says, went into the heart of Aba Abdullah. The other three-headed arrow went into that mashkiza that Hazrat Abbas were carrying for Sakina. And you know where the third arrow was. The largest arrow pierced the smallest neck on the day of Ashura. A baby so small that when this arrow pierced Ali Asghar, this baby turned on the hands of Aba Abdullah. Ajrakum ala Allah. Where do I begin the musibah? Imam Hussein alayhi salatu wasalam, when the arrow pierced his heart, he sat on the ground. And as he sat on the ground, another arrow came into the forehead of Aba Abdullah. As another arrow came in the forehead of Aba Abdullah, another arrow came into the neck of Aba Abdullah. At that moment, Imam Hussein did not have any more energy. He dropped his sword. He removed the arrow from his neck. And he said that a spring of blood came out of the neck. You know what he does? He takes the blood from his neck and he rubs it on his beard. And he says, I will meet my grandfather Rasulullah like this. But you know what I want to take you today is when Imam Hussein was in his final moments, his eyes were closed. There was confusion amongst the enemy. They said, we don't know if Hussein is alive or not. His eyes are closed. He's not moving. Ajrukum ala Allah. Imam Hussein had reached a stage where he could no longer move. But you know what they said? They said there's only one way to test if Hussein is alive or not. You know what they said? They said, go and attack the tent of Zainab. Hussein is very sensitive about Zainab. Hussein is very protective about Zainab. As they turn the horses towards the khaymah of Zainab, the Maqtal says Hussein opens his eyes and he says, and he grabs on the ground, he brings him up, he brings himself up with his elbows and he says, oh enemies of Allah, Hussein is alive, don't you dare go near Zainab. But I say, oh Aba Abdullah, you were so protective, but on Darbar, when they came in Safar into the Darbar of Yazid, When Zainab entered the Bazar Sham, Ajrakum Allah, the Hussein was so protective about Zainab Kubra. How imagine the sabr of Sayyid Sajjad, who saw it with his own eyes. One of the Zakirin in Iran, Haj Ali Tabrizi, he saw a dream one night. He saw the 12th Imam. When he saw the 12th Imam, he asked him a question. He says, Mawla, in Ziyaratun Nahiya, is it true what you say that you cry tears of blood? Ajrakum Allah, brothers, we cry water. The 12th Imam cried tears of blood. He says, Mawla, is it true? He says, yes, is it true? He sits down in front of the Imam. He says, Mawla, tell me, what is it that makes you cry tears of blood? Is it the Shahadat of Ali Akbar? He cries, he says, no. The Shahadat of Ali Akbar was a azim Shahadat, but it wasn't that. He says, Mawla, tell me, was it when they cut the arms of Abbas? He says, that was a great Shahadat for us. But no, it wasn't the Shahadat of Abbas that makes me cry blood. He says, tell me, was it when they trampled the body of Abba Abdullah under the hooves of the horses? He says, no, that was an azim Shahadat for us. But it wasn't that. He says, Mawla, then what was it that makes you cry blood? Sabahan wa masaa. Day and night you cry blood. You know what he says? The 12th Imam says to him, he says, I cry blood for what they did to my aunt Zainab. How they tied her hands behind her neck. How they pulled her through the bazaar. How they brought Zainab in the Bazar Sham. And you know what they said? When Shimar and Umar Asad made them enter the bazaar, that bazaar belonged to who? The Yehud of Khaybar. He came out and he says, oh people of Khaybar, if you want to take revenge from Ali, then this is the daughter of Ali. This is the daughter of Fatima. اجرکم علی اللہ اجرکم علی اللہ بھئی دو جملے مجلس تمام ہو گئی بھئی جناب زینب کبریٰ کو بازار سے لایا گیا جانتے ہیں روایت میں کیا ملتا ہے جناب زینب کبریٰ ایک صحابی ہے سہل بن سعدی انصاری صحابی ہیں انصار آئے کہا کہ کون ہے جب دیکھا کہ اہل حرم ہیں دیکھا کہ کچھ بیبیاں ہیں کچھ سر ہیں کچھ نوک نیزہ پہ سر بلند ہیں کچھ بیبیاں ہیں ایک بیبی کی آغوش میں ایک ننی سی بچی ہے بھئی دو جملے زحمت تمام ننی سی بچی ہے قریب آگئے کہا کہ بی بی آپ کون ہیں کہا میں سکینہ بنت الحسین ہوں کہا بی بی آپ کون ہیں کہا میں علی کی بیٹی ہوں بی بی کا سر جھکا ہوا ہے بالوں سے چہرہ ڈھپا اپنا چہرہ چھپایا ہوا ہے ایک جملہ کہا بی بی میں رسول خدا کا صحابی ہوں حکم کیجئے بی بی نے کہا جا ایک کام کر اگر کچھ پیسے ہیں تو شمر کو پیسے دے اور اسے کہہ دے کہ یہ شہداء کے سروں کو آگے لے جائے تاکہ تمام تماشا دیکھنے والوں کی نظریں سروں پہ ہو زینب کے سر پہ کسی کی نظر نہ پڑے کیونکہ جب بھی کسی نامحرم کی نظر زینب کے سر پہ پڑتی تھی میرا مولا سجاد منہ کے بل زمین پہ گرتا تھا آخری جملہ جب جناب زینب کو باب الساعات پہ کھڑا کیا گیا نا تو کہا جب تھوڑی دیر کے بعد کہا کہ اب آپ دربار میں داخل ہو جائیں بی بی نے کہا نہیں جاؤں گی میں علی کی بیٹی ہوں میں فاطمہ کی عزت ہوں میں دربار میں نہیں جاؤں گی امام سجاد نے کہا پھوپھی اممہ ذرا بابا حسین کے سر کو دیکھئے اب جب ایک بہن نے بھائی کے سر کو دیکھا تو حسین کی آنکھوں سے آنسو بہ رہے تھے لیکن ایک جملہ کہا بہن زینب دربار میں چلے جائیے میں نے نانا سے وعدہ کیا تھا اسلام کی خاطر سب کچھ لٹا دوں گا اجرکم علی اللہ آخری جملہ اور اس کے بعد ماتم بس عزاداروں جب بیبیوں کو دربار میں لایا گیا نا تو سب کا تعارف کروایا گیا پہلے سروں کو لایا گیا کہا یہ حسین کا سر ہے یہ عباس کا سر ہے یہ قاسم کا سر ہے بھئی ماں بہنوں کے سامنے
करियल जवान अकबर है, किसी का बेटा है, फिर एक बहुत छोटा सर है। कहा ये किसका सर है? कहा ये हुसैन का सबसे छोटा बेटा, भाई जो सबसे ज्यादा प्यासा था। भाई जहमत तमाम हो गई, अजरकुम अल्लाह, मौला कोई गम न दे सिवाय गम हुसैन के। आखिरी जुमला जहमत तमाम। एक मर्तबा यजीद सामने आया, फिर उसने कहा मन हाज़े ही, ये बीबी कौन है? फिर कहा मन हाज़े ही, ये बीबी कौन है? अब जालिमों ने नबी जादियों के नाम लेना शुरू किए, कहा कि सबको हटा दिया जाए, बस जैनब यहां पे रहे। बस आजादारों इसी पे जुमला तमाम कर रहा हूं, जैनब यहां पे रहे। जालिम तक तलवारें निकाली, नेजे निकाले, तमाम बीबियों को हटाना शुरू किया, एक बीबी नहीं हटी। जानते हैं कौन? अम्मा फिजा। फिजा ने फातिमा से वादा किया था, जब तक जिंदा रहूंगी आपके बच्चों का ख्याल रखूंगी। बस जब जालिम ने फिजा को ताजियाना मारा ना, अबे फिज़ा को जलाल आ गया। यजीद के पीछे हबशी गुलाम थे, कहा अब हबशी गुलामों तुम्हारी गैरत कहां मर गई है? तुम्हारे सामने तुम्हारे कबीले की एक औरत पे ताजियाना उठा रहे हैं, ताजियाना मार रहे हैं। बस इतना कहा था, हबशी गुलामों को गैरत, उनकी गैरत जाग गई। कहा यजीद अगर इन्हें छोड़ा ना गया तो खून की नदियां बहा देंगे। बस आजादारों कितनी मजलूम है ज़ैनब कुबरा। इस वक्त ज़ैनब ने करबला का रुख किया, फिर नजफ का रुख किया, कहा बाबा अली आज ज़ैनब कितनी मजलूम हो गई, गुलामों को बचाने वाले बहुत हैं, ज़ैनब को कोई बचाने वाला नहीं है। बस आजादारों ये वो बीबी थी जो फातिमा की घर की इज्जत थी। बस आजादारों ये वो बीबी थी जो अब्बास की बहन थी। अला लानतुल्लाह अलल कौम अज़्ज़ालिमीन व सयअलमु अल्लज़ीना ज़लमू अय्यामुन क़लबिन यनक़लिबून वल आक़िबतु लिल मुत्तक़ीन मातम हुसैन।